Welcome back to my channel Astral Dimension. So in this one particular podcast, we are going to discuss how astrology and different signs and different planets affect our communication. Usually, communication is a very big and major part of a person's life, and how through astrology we can see that which planet and which sign can manipulate our conversation and the way in which we communicate to what extent. So in this one particular podcast, I am going to kind of explain each and every planet, how that particular planet is linked with our communication and how each and every zodiac sign is linked with our communication. So you have to see your major planet, then you have to see how each planet is influencing your communication. Now see, in astrology, we always categorize that this planet is connected with this, this planet is connected with that. So we only compartmentalize each and every beauty of a planet. Like for example, we consider soul as to be sun. We consider our main communication through Mercury. We consider our aggression through Mars. But this is not true. Every planet has a personality and every planet has some part of that specific area that we are studying. So if we are talking about communication, if we are talking about the way in which we communicate and deliver our thoughts and ideas to other person, we have to see each and every planet. And along with that, we also have to see the time period. The time period, the Mahadasha, the Antardasha, Paryantardasha, everything, so that we can devise that in this one particular time period, we are going to have this kind of conversation and this kind of communication. So let us understand the dynamic of communication through astrological point of view. So first, we are going to discuss planets and then we see which sign is ruled by that particular planet and then we will study according to that. So number one, we are going to see Sun. And through Sun, we will see the sign of Leo as well. So firstly, let us understand Sun. What is Sun doing in the area of communication? Sun signifies the amount of authority, the amount of dominance and amount of ego we are bringing in our communication, in our conversation. So suppose a person who has a very strong Sun is communicating with you, you will always have this problem that how I can convey myself in a better way because this one particular individual is not letting me talk. So that particular person is bringing strong dominance and authority in the conversation. He will always talk in such a way that he is giving you orders. He is trying to exert his dominance and authority over you. And the problem is that the ego will be so high that if any other person is interrupting him or any other person is disturbing him while he is talking, then he will become really aggressive. So Sun signifies the amount of dominance we want to put, the amount of force we are putting in that particular conversation. And along with that, Sun also signifies that whether we are protecting anyone through our conversation or not. So it can see a very, it can show a very structured way of communication where he has certain agenda in his mind that I am communicating so that I can protect this community, or I am communicating or having a conversation so that I can protect my ideologies. So Sun signifies the amount of dominance and authority. Now Leo, and the sign of Leo is connected with Sun. So what is sign of Leo doing in that particular conversation? Sign of Leo is adding the drama. So if you have majority of your planets in the sign of Leo, or if anyhow Dasha runs of a particular planet who has its place in the sign of Leo, then that particular person will create drama through his conversation, through his communication, and he will be so much attractive to drama as well. So anywhere if fight is happening or anywhere two people are arguing, then he will enjoy that particular situation because Leo is all about magnificence and drama. So through his communication, he will try to add that level of spice in the conversation. So sign of Leo and Sun are connected with dominance, power and magnificence that is being added up to the conversation and communication. Now Moon. What is Moon doing in the communication area? And along with Moon, we are going to discuss Cancer as well. So Moon is the emotions, Moon is the vulnerability, Moon is the feelings that you are bringing in your conversation. So if a person who has a very strong Moon, or generally if we see what Moon is doing in the conversation area, so Moon is adding the dryness or the warmth in the conversation. By talking to some individual, we feel really heard. We feel like other person is really listening to us. and that warmth, that comfort is given through moon. If a person has, suppose, moon in the sign of Capricorn, then it will become really difficult to convey your thoughts to them. Why? Because they will be constantly judging you through the practical glasses. They will have very practical and logical approach. So you will feel, especially if a person has moon in Libra or moon in Cancer, he will feel really frustrated at how I can communicate with this particular individual. He is not listening to me. He has no feelings, no emotions. But the exception is that if moon is present in the sign of Capricorn in second house, then that particular conversation is little different. That is very sensual conversation. So it is a exception that I have seen. But yes, moon in Capricorn is really very dramatic and dry sign. Also, moon signifies vulnerability. If a person is capable of bringing his emotions in the conversation, if person is able to explain himself very well and to connect with the masses, because sign of Cancer is also of masses. So if a person has the capability to connect with masses, that is seen through moon and also the sign of Cancer. If a sign of Cancer is very well placed, then person has the capability that he can connect with majority of people at same time. It may not be some political rally, but no matter where he is present in his own society, in his own cultural background, in his own workplace, he will be very well heard because he will be capable of invoking the emotions in other people. So feelings and emotions are seen through moon in our conversation. Now let's talk about Mars. What is Mars doing in the conversation area and the communication sector? And along with Mars, you will see Scorpio and Aries. Now, Mars is the fact. Mars does not understand logic. Mars is real fact. And along with fact, Mars is also our weapon. So, anywhere Mars is present, that particular area becomes a weapon area. So, if we are seeing what Mars is bringing in the conversation, Mars is bringing passion. There are some people who are so mellow or very... we can say they lack some kind of fire and passion that we don't feel really connected while talking to them because they don't have that kind of passion for anything that they are talking about. So that passion is seen through Mars. If a person is lacking passion, if a person has a very not very well placed Mars, then that person will not be able to bring the passion or they will not be able to invoke the passion inside you. So Mars signifies that what kind of aggression and fire you are bringing in the conversation. There are some people who can debate to such a great extent that even though you are losing against them, still you will enjoy that debate because they will be so fierce and so passionate about the topic about which they are talking about. So that particular passion is seen through Mars and also violence. If a person is using abusive language or not, if a person is using very bad body language while communicating, there are some people who can really piss you off while they are talking. So that kind of body language is also seen through Mars. Now, Scorpio. Scorpio can invoke fear while communicating. If a person has a very strong sign of Scorpio in the chart and many planets sitting in that particular sign, then that particular individual will create mystery around them through their communication. They will give you just hints. They will talk in certain codes and in certain language that you may not be able to fully decode. But they will give you that kind of charm and that kind of secrecy that you will want to know more. Their storytelling way will be very strong and very profound. At the same time, they can give you fear. So they can say something that can invoke a sense of fear inside you that what if what they are saying can get true. So that kind of fear is being generated by the sign of Scorpio. Aries, on the other hand, is very hyperactive sign. So if we see Aries, what is Aries contributing in the area of communication, then Aries is selfishness. So if a Aries dominated person is talking to you, they will have much more influence on their own belief system, their own personality. They will always say that I believe this, I feel this, I want to do this, I want to change your perception, I am starting this. So their focus will be on I part more and very fast and aggressive speaker. So they will try to destroy you through their speech. That is seen through the sign of Aries. Now if we see Jupiter, what is Jupiter doing in the area of communication and conversation and what Sagittarius and Pisces is doing? So if we see Jupiter, Jupiter is bringing what kind of knowledge you hold in your conversations, in your communication. Now Mercury and Jupiter both have this area of knowledge, but the knowledge of Jupiter is very much profound. So if a Jupiterian person is talking to you, you will naturally get a sense of respect that yes, they are talking some sense or they have much more higher knowledge than me. So Jupiterian quality is such that whenever they are speaking, first of all, they will not speak they will not talk to everyone. They will have a very selected few people with whom they will be comfortable in talking. So when they are talking, they don't want interruption. Again, some sense of ego is also present in Jupiter as well, because it is guru, it is the mentor, the guide, the teacher, the advisor. So it does not want to get interrupted. At the same time, they will be bringing their past life expertise, their past life knowledge in the conversation. So a very profound, deep knowledge, and they will use such heavy words, they will use such heavy shlokas or heavy proverbs in their communication that it will give a very philosophical touch. It will give a very you will feel like the person is very intellectual, they have a very strong sense of literature, they have a very strong sense of the topic about which they are talking about. So Jupiter brings that kind of respect. So we also see respect through Jupiter, that what kind of respect this person will get through his communication and conversations. Now Sagittarius is bringing a kind of belief system. Sagittarius person will only speak about their own beliefs. So if a Sagittarius person is talking to you, they will constantly tell you that what they are saying and why they are saying that and why it is right. So that kind of stubbornness is created to the sign of Sagittarius. At the same time, a person who has very strong Sagittarius cannot understand criticism. They will just back out, or they will try to make you feel inferior, but they cannot handle defeat, they cannot handle criticism in their conversations and communication. At the same time, a Sagittarius sign is also seen with initiating violence, initiating some kind of mass movement. So Sagittarius will pump you so high that you will feel like, yes, he is saying and he is making sense, he is saying something right. And he can invoke crowds, he can invoke masses. So Sagittarius is a little bit dangerous sign according to me, because Sagittarius can influence and manipulate people to a very great extent, because they will use their knowledge to brainwash other people. So that is also seen, that this is a negative side of Jupiter, we can say. In the sign of Pisces, they will try to make you come out of the illusion, they will try to show you the reality. Now Pisces is a very strong sign. So if a person has a very strong Pisces, they will have a very strong understanding of topic, they will have a very in-depth knowledge. But the problem is that their intuition and imagination can sometimes become very high, and it will become difficult for other people to understand and grasp the topic they are talking about, because Pisces is all over the place. So they may not be able to construct their sentences or construct their communication in a short space. They will need a very large time period. They will need a very large space to talk about. So they cannot talk in front of everyone. They cannot talk very fast. They cannot talk in a boundary. They require their own space. They require their own comfort level, and they require maximum time to talk. Many spiritual leaders, many spiritual sages have this one particular placement of Pisces, or they have a very strong sign of Pisces, because Pisces is real knowledge. All the knowledge that Jupiter wants to convey is present in a sign of Pisces. Now, what kind of help is given in the area of communication through Venus and Libra and Taurus? So Venus signifies your capability of research. If you are constantly researching your facts, if you are researching and using some kind of in-depth knowledge that has not been shared before. Why? Because Venus is Shukracharya. Shukracharya has this capability of bringing the facts, and even bringing the facts from dead. So as we all know about Sanjeevani Shakti from the Shukracharya, so he has that particular Shakti. So he has the capability of knowing the unknown. So if a person who has very strong, well-placed Venus, or they have strong signs of Venus in their chart, so they will back their conversation, they will back their communication by their own research. They will have very in-depth research about topics. They will not just say or blurt out things. They will have a very strong their research database, that why they are saying that or why they have that kind of knowledge. So Jupiter is not going to give you fact or logic. He will want you to believe him, and you will believe him. But Venus, as he is a Daitya Guru, he is Shukracharya, he will tell you that, see, this is why I am telling you this. So he needs to back his words, he needs to back his knowledge. So he will give you knowledge. So research is seen through Venus. At the same time, Venus is beauty of conversation. If a person is talking and you are just mesmerized by the information, by the way in which they are conveying their message, or by their facial expressions, or how they are conducting themselves, or how beautifully they are speaking the language. So that kind of beauty is also seen through Venus. beauty is also artistic conversations and artistic communication. So if a person is expressing themselves through their art forms, it can be dance, it can be music, it can be any photography. So if a person is conveying their message through their art form, that is also the talent of Venus. Now, the sign of Libra signifies diplomacy. If you are capable of using diplomacy in your conversations and communication, that is seen through the sign of Libra. And if a person has strong Libra sign, it tends to get a little bit people-pleasing tendencies. You cannot say no very fiercely. It will be very few times when you will say no with a very straight face. It will be very difficult for such people. At the same time, this is a masculine sign. So yes, they will be very strong in proving themselves. They will be very strong in getting two people on the same point. So due to their diplomacy, they will try to mediate the conversation. They will try to give directions to the conversation. So you can feel like I am defeating this person, but if a person has a very strong Libra, they will ultimately bring you to their own point of view. So this is a strong sign. The sign of Taurus. Sign of Taurus is a little bit stubborn sign. As we all know, this is an earth sign. And in the sign of Taurus, a person adds value to their conversation. They will add value. How they can add value to their conversation? See, if a person who has a very strong Taurus in their sign, they will usually pinpoint their achievements. They will pinpoint what they have in their life. They will pinpoint their family values. They will pinpoint how great lineage they have connection with. So they will always try to bring value in the conversation through their own achievements or through their own assets or through the hard work they have put into their work. So if a person has a Taurus, a very strong Taurus, they will always say things that you will listen and you will think that yes, he has achieved something in his life. So that kind of dominance is being given to the sign of Taurus. Dominance in the way that you will feel like, yes, they are a person of some material wealth. They are a person of some material strength. So that is seen through the sign of Taurus. Now, if we see what kind of things are being given to the area of communication through Mercury. Mercury is signified with conversations and communication. Mercury is the area with which we see communication. So Mercury has a major say in the area of communication. What is Mercury doing basically? Mercury is the way in which we speak. Mercury is the basic communication and conversations. And Mercury signifies your ease of communication. How easily you can speak up. How easily you can interact with other people. How comfortable your nervous system is to interact with other people. So if Mercury is damaged, if Mercury is not well placed, no matter how strong your other planets are, you will not be able to speak up at the correct time. You will not be able to tell your viewpoint even if you are extremely intelligent person in the room. And that is why we consider our communication, our conversations through Mercury. We connected with that. Why? Because this is the ease of communication. This is the major area of communication and conversations. So if Mercury is not well placed, then again, there is a big problem, a major problem in your area of communication and conversations. So Mercury is natural communication capability. Now what is Gemini and Virgo doing? Virgo is your calculation. How quickly you calculate that whether I should speak in this particular situation or not. Whether I should be silent or I should speak up. So where is my profit? So if you are sensible and if you know how businessmen and business deals work, then you should know that sign of Virgo is very important aspect of conversations and communication. Because if you have a very negative planet in that particular sign, or if you don't have that strong Virgo in your chart, then the capability to understand when to speak, how to speak, and with whom to speak will not be very strong. So Virgo is your sensibility while talking, while communicating. What is Gemini? Gemini is the charmer. How quickly you charm other person in your conversation. Suppose you are talking to one person and your topic is so intriguing, your topic is so interesting that other people around you start to join that conversation. So this is the Gemini energy. That how charmingly you are attracting other people in your topic. And the sign of Gemini is the manipulator. I have told this many times. Sign of Gemini is very strong sign. And this is a natural manipulator. So even though it does not have any knowledge, any information, any research, any truthfulness to their topic, still they will be able to take out your money for their communication and for their the way in which they are convincing you. So their convincing power is so high that even if they are lying to you, some kind of Rahu kind of quality, still you will be convinced that no, they are telling the truth. And they will have awareness about their surrounding. They will quickly understand that what they can say. They will quickly analyze that what kind of situation their words are creating. So they will change their words very quickly. So that is a very chameleon kind of energy. Now, what is Rahu doing in the area of conversations? And before Rahu, let us understand Saturn as well. Saturn is a tamas, pure tamas, and Saturn creates a situation of fear in the conversation. The fear that may cause you some trouble while your conversations are going on. So the sign of Saturn is a naturally dry sign, as we all know, and Saturn creates situation where no matter what kind of knowledge you have, still you prefer to be silent because you don't want to draw attention towards you. So that kind of fear is created by Saturn. And if a Saturn is very strong in chart, then you will try to raise your voice. You will try to speak minimum words, but you will always use your words very carefully. And you will use your words as they are very valuable resources. So you will not waste many words in any conversation because you want to hold your energy. And at the same time, Saturn wants power from the dominant people so that that power can be used for the underprivileged people. So Saturn will speak up when he will sense a sun energy around him. So if a person is being too dominant or too authoritative, then Saturn will get triggered and it will communicate and it will speak that no, you are being dominant, you are being rude, and you should listen to the other person who is trying to communicate with you. So that kind of justice is being given to the Saturn. And Saturn brings the justice in the conversations, in the communication. So if you are unjust, if you are corrupt in your conversation, that is seen through Saturn. And if you are extremely a justice loving person, it is also seen through Saturn. That what kind of genuine interest about other person you have in your conversation. So if you are just gossiping, that is not Saturn energy. But if you are doing conversations on topic which are very important to other people, then that is Saturn energy. Now, Capricorn is again the power. Capricorn wants to speak very limited words. Capricorn wants to save their energy. But any time a Capricorn dominated person want to speak, they want to exert power. Just like Sun, but for other people. So they will not talk about themselves. They will talk about other people. They will talk about struggles of other people. What is Aquarius doing? Aquarius is bringing innovation. Aquarius is bringing ideas. So when an Aquarius person senses that all these people are not making sense and they need some kind of innovation, they need some kind of guidance in their conversation, then an Aquarius dominated person will try to speak. And the problem with Aquarius person is that you may not be able to understand them very quickly. You will judge them and you will think that they are not making sense, but they are the only people who are making sense in the room. So Aquarius is a very misunderstood sign, and a person who has very strong Aquarius energy, they will have this one trauma in their life that why nobody understands them. Now what is Rahu doing in the conversation and communication area? As we all know, Rahu is illusion. So Rahu, the work of Rahu is how much illusion you can create in your conversation, which is a very, very important aspect in today's time. If you cannot create a bubble, if you cannot create a cloud of your own ideas in front of other people, then you are failing in the sector of your communication. So you need Rahu in your conversation. I'm not telling you that you need Rahu to tell lies. No, you need Rahu to create a cloud in front of other people that whatever you are telling them, that is very big, that is huge. And also through Rahu, we see fake news. Through Rahu, we see rumors. Through Rahu, we see a sense of selling or convincing. So convincing power is also seen through Rahu. What is Ketu doing? Ketu is literally doing nothing in the area of conversation and communication. It is cutting conversation. So if a person who has very strong Ketu in their chart, they are literally trying to get away from any kind of conversation, especially low level conversations, and they will cut conversations very quickly. So you will ask them what is going on in their life. They will just say nothing and they will end it and they will move away. So Ketu is sharp objects, and Ketu is signifying a very short, to the point, cutter like conversations. So Ketu is literally very, very rude personality, and Ketu will not like to hear lies because Ketu know the real power is in silence. So Ketu is a very weird energy, and Ketu is literally not doing very much in the area of communication, but it is the cutting, the end of conversations. So that is seen through Ketu. But whenever a Ketu dominated person wants to speak, then it is a treat to watch. Because Ketu rarely speaks, and when Ketu speaks, if you have heard Mr. J. Krishnamurti, so that is Ketu talking. So that is a very different kind of a conversation. So I hope you will enjoy this one particular podcast. So if you have some questions and doubts, you can ask me in the comment section. I will clear them out. Thank you.